Mike Thomas, a good friend of mine. Hands together, all right? Come on.
All right, let's keep it going for Monique Urto, everybody. Monique Urto, all right. What's up, Foxtrot? How you doing? Okay, well, one knock and that's it. Thank you for having us in here. Thank you for coming out and supporting live comedy or just randomly coming into a pub that's doing comedy. My name is Mike Thomas, and is that what happened with you guys?
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe. No, I think yes. I think I can tell yes. That's okay, though. So, I'm making you laugh already? That's good. No, no, not yet? Okay. So, my first joke, there's a few of the professional comedians, I don't want to name names of town, they went to Toronto, and they filmed this comedy show, and apparently they got all drunk on CTV's budget, and started teasing me and making fun of me about this joke. One of them was actually on this evening, and so, what it's done is it's kind of re-inspired me to start telling that joke again, all these guys who are hopefully making fun of me for good reasons and not for bad reasons. So, smart cars are stupid. Stupid smart cars. I love that one because it's compact. Come back like a smart car. Hey. What I actually wanted to do for that joke is, like, when I'm going to be showcasing that in the fall for Just for Laughs and Halifax and all that, is I wanted to do sparklers at the end of the joke. I thought that would have worked out better, but Fire Hazard wouldn't allow that. So I go, hey, and then I'd like sparklers. And that's how I do that one. Thank you very much. So the third hardest thing about being a homeless midget is dumpster diving. Just try and close your eyes and imagine that poor little fella trying to scamper up the side of the dumpster. The second hardest thing about being a homeless midget is, of course, getting back out of the dumpster. And the hardest thing about being a homeless midget is that people are always calling you the littlest hobo. That could break someone's spirit living out on the street. You die right there. You're looking away in shame, I think, by that last joke. That's all right. So Canada is the only North American country whose elected leader has never been assassinated. I'm just throwing that out to all you record breakers. Don't you think it's about time that we join that club? Thank you very much. Apparently I'm not the only one who doesn't like Stephen Harper. Shoot right between those wolf eyes of his. That was a reference to a Daryl Bedford joke. Maybe I'll do a Daryl Bedford joke. Because sometimes when I find a lull in my set, what I like to do is I like to steal a joke from another comedian. A joke that I've seen before that makes me laugh. So what I'd like to do is a new joke by Daryl Bedford. Hopefully I can remember. So, shooting a gun is kind of like firing a hooker. Actually, it's exactly the same. That's about murdering a prostitute. I thought it was funny. DarylBedfordPresents.com. Buy his shit. That was a plug for Daryl Bedford. He's at another show right now. So I was on the Sky Train, and across from me there's a mom with her two daughters. The daughters were about 7 and 4. And what they're doing to pass the time was there playing hangman. The older daughter was the hangman, and the younger was trying to guess. And how she was trying to guess was by singing the ABC song. So she'd go, ABC, is it C? And her sister went, yes, it's C, and wrote that down. So she guessed the game. She went, ABCD, is it D? And her sister went, no, it isn't D, it drew a little arm on the hangman. But then she guessed, ABCDE, is it 4? And her mom heard that, corrected her, and said, no, love, 4 is a number, not a letter. I smiled at that, then laughed, so loud and long that the mom turned around and looked at me. I stopped, composed myself, and said, I'm sorry, it's just, you have a very stupid child. Thank you very much. Thank you. I'd like to welcome to the stage, that's the highest point of it, Monique Herzo, everybody.